This is Operation Swordfish and take 3. First time I was rudely interrupted by a phone call, and the second time I screwed up the sound, so this is the third time I'm recording this one. Probably because of the crack group or something, the game starts right away when I skip this one, so here we go. In this game you have two different modes. You go underwater like this. Okay, went back straight out. Okay. So you have two modes. One is this underwater mode where the boats can't hurt you, but you can sink them. And then you have the above water mode where you can shoot the airplanes down. Oh, there's an airplane. Too slow. But in this mode the boats can shoot you, so just to... Okay. Ah, you can actually aim up and down. Quickly! Dive! Dive, you bastard. Yep. Now we are safe from the boats. It's a bit strange to do this because you have a very little idea where the torpedo is going. Do you if you have to aim forward, or do you have to aim where the boat is at? I guess you have to lead the target to hit. But it's really difficult to lead because you don't see where the torpedo is. Oh, airplane. Dive! Dive, you bastard! Oh, here we go again. It would be much easier to do this game if you actually saw the torpedoes where they are. Now you just have to guess. That and how about that? Oh, airplane. Quickly. Switch. There's a small delay between switching the station, so maybe if I can. And when you're submerged, you have no way of killing those airplanes. Yeah, I think you have to lead the targets quickly up. Yeah. By the time you get up, it's usually too late to hit the bloody airplanes. It's not a bad game. It was really aggravating at first because I didn't know there are... You can go up. You can go man the machine gun, but because I screwed up the recording twice, I had had the chance to learn the function keys actually do something in this game. Yay for that! So that's Operation Swordfish for you. I'm not going to record this one again, so this has to do. Thanks for watching.